Danke per seguir con nosotros. Mente Marcos Dani Williams, y esa que tiene noticia internacional. Miembro non permanente di Consejo di Sicurezza di Nazioni Unite, mester mantenendo mes estrictamente la carta di Nazioni Unite. Así, el secretario general de Nazioni Unite, Antonio Guterres, ha declarado en el Consejo di Sicurezza di Nazioni Unite después que Merca, Francia y Reino Unido lanzaron ataques en aéreo contra el gobierno de Siria. El más alto ejecutivo de Nazioni Unite, Guterres, ha enfatizado que no tiene una solución militar en la guerra complicada de Siria, mester hay una solución política. El secretario general de Naciones Unidas, Antonio Guterres, declarando una miembro de poderoso Consejo de Seguridad de Naciones Unidas.
Mr. President, Excellencies, I have been following closely the reports of airstrikes in Syria conducted by the United States, France and the United Kingdom. Last night at 22 hours of New York, the US President announced the beginning of airstrikes with participation by France and the UK, indicating they were targeting the chemical weapons capabilities of the Syrian government and to deter their future use. His statement was followed by announcements from Prime Minister May and President Macron. The airstrikes were reportedly limited to three military locations inside Syria. The first target included the Syrian Scientific Studies and Research Center at Al-Maza Airport in Damascus. The second, an alleged chemical weapons storage facility west of Homs. And the third, an alleged chemical weapons equipment storage site and command post also near Homs. The Syrian government announced surface-to-air missile response activity. Both U.S. and Russian sources indicated there were no civilian casualties. The UN is, however, unable to independently verify the details of all these reports. Mr. President, as Secretary General of the United Nations, it is my duty to remind member states that there is an obligation, particularly when dealing with matters of peace and security, to act consistently with the Charter of the United Nations and with international law in general. The UN Charter is very clear on these issues. Mr. President, the Security Council has primary responsibility for the maintenance of international peace and security. I call on the members of the Security Council to unite and exercise that responsibility. And I urge all members to show restraint in these dangerous circumstances and to avoid any acts that could escalate matters and worsening the suffering of the Syrian people. As I did yesterday, I stressed the need to avoid the situation from spiraling out of control. Mr. President, any use of chemical weapons is abhorrent. The suffering it causes is horrendous. I have repeatedly expressed my deep disappointment that the Security Council failed to agree on a dedicated mechanism for effective accountability for the use of chemical weapons in Syria. I urge the Security Council to assume its responsibilities and fill this gap. And I will continue to engage with member states to help achieve this objective. A lack of accountability emboldens those who would use such weapons by providing them with the reassurance of impunity. And this, in turn, further weakens the norm proscribing the use of chemical weapons and the international disarmament and non-proliferation architecture as a whole. Mr. President, the seriousness of the recent allegations of the use of chemical weapons in Douma requires a thorough investigation using impartial, independent and professional expertise. I reaffirm my full support for the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, the OPCW, and its fact-finding mission in undertaking the required investigation. The team is already in Syria. I am informed that their operations plan to visit the site is completed and that they are ready to go. I am confident they will have full access without any restrictions or impediments to perform their activities. Mr. President, allow me to repeat what I said yesterday. Syria today represents the most serious threat to international peace and security. In Syria, we see confrontations and proxy wars involving several national armies, a number of armed opposition groups, many national and international militia, foreign fighters from everywhere in the world, and various terrorist organizations. From the beginning, we have witnessed systematic violations of international humanitarian law, international human rights law, and international law tout court in utter disregard of the letter and spirit of the United Nations Charter. For 8 long years, the people of Syria have endured suffering upon suffering. Syrians have lived through a litany of horrors, atrocity crimes, sieges, starvation, indiscriminate attacks against civilians and civilian infrastructure, the use of chemical weapons, forced displacement, sexual violence, torture, detention, and enforced disappearances. The list goes on. At this critical juncture, I call on all members to act consistently with the Charter of the United Nations and international law, including the norms against chemical weapons. If the law is ignored, it is undermined. There is no military solution to the crisis. The solution must be political. We must find ways to make credible progress towards a genuine and credible political solution that meets the aspirations of the Syrian people to dignity and freedom in accordance with Resolution 2254 and the Geneva Communique. I've asked my special envoy to come to New York as soon as possible to consult with me on the most effective way to accelerate the political process. Thank you, Mr. President.
Forse na holandese nota forma parte di attacco in incontri di Egobiar di Siria, según el minister di relación exterior di Reino Holandese Stef Blok. For di Bruselas e la papia e tabisa merca no ani puntra Holanda pa join e attacca anche tampoco, però Holanda tin comprensión total pa e action americano, britannico e francese na Siria. E minister ta enfatizza si cu Holanda ta di opinión cuto cu diplomacia so per solucionar e conflicto anche.
Rusland speelt natuurlijk een cruciale rol in Syrië, dus het is wat ons betreft logisch om dat via de Veiligheidsraad te doen, waar Rusland natuurlijk lid van is, waar ze tot nu toe de vredesprocessen steeds geblokkeerd hebben. Maar we moeten blijven proberen om via de Veiligheidsraad weer gang te krijgen in allereerst een wapenstilstand, humanitaire hulp en uiteindelijk ook een vredesproces.
Maar wat kan er vandaag gebeuren? Wat kan Europa, wat kan de Europese Unie doen eigenlijk?
Eensgezind voor deze lijn kiezen. De oplossing moet echt komen via politiek overleg, via de VN-veiligheidsraad. Allereerst hulp en ook zo snel mogelijk een vredesproces. Ja,
maar het is zo dat de Fransen hebben samen met Amerika eigenlijk bombardementen uitgevoerd. De rest van Europa is een beetje aan de zijlijn. Europa blijkt niet zo eensgezind, of is dat een illusie?
Nederland heeft begrip uitgesproken voor de uitgevoerde acties. We zijn ook niet om hulp gevraagd. Dus je kunt niet zeggen dat we niet eensgezind zijn. We hebben ons begrip laten blijken voor de acties. Want het is verschrikkelijk wat er gebeurd is met die aanval in Doel.
Segundo el minister para relación exterior de Reino Holandés, Blok, na el momento dan aquí no tiene una proposición riba mesa para sancionar europeo of holandés tampoco contra de Rusia.
De Franse president Macron heeft al opgeroepen dat hij Rusland en onder andere ook Turkije terug wil aan de onderhandelingstafel. Steunt Nederland dat?
Dat is het soort onderhandelingen waar we heen moeten. Rusland moet aan tafel en de landen in de omgeving moeten aan tafel. Want alleen via onderhandelingen kunnen we hier uitkomen.
En sancties, waar bijvoorbeeld ook in de Verenigde Staten over wordt gesproken?
Ja, op dit moment liggen die opties niet concreet op tafel. En uiteindelijk, met of zonder sancties, de echte oplossing komt van onderhandelen. Partijen om de tafel, wapenstilstand, hulp en zo snel mogelijk echte vredesonderhandelingen.
Ja, dus u ziet geen heil in nieuwe sancties tegen Syrië?
Nou, op dit moment is de volle inzet van de Nederlandse regering echt gericht op onderhandelen. Allereerst hulp het land in. En zo snel mogelijk echt een politieke oplossing.
Wat zou hier vandaag met uw Europese collega's kunnen afspreken dat dat dichterbij brengt?
Dat we eensgezind zijn in deze lijn. Als Europa eensgezind optreedt, dan zijn we natuurlijk een kracht van belang. En dat zal vandaag ook mijn inzet zijn.
Ja, en bent u dan opgelucht dat nu dat een confrontatie met de Russen is uitgebleven over afgelopen weekend?
Het was in ieder geval een proportionele actie, vandaar dat de Nederlandse regering ook begrip heeft uitgesproken. En nu is de inzet echt om weer naar de onderhandelingstafel toe te koersen. Eerst hulp aan de mensen in Syrië en dan zo snel mogelijk een vredesproces.
Maar bent u opgelucht dat een directe confrontatie met Rusland is uitgebleven?
Ja, het is niet zo dat ik nou nagelbijtend op mijn stoel zat. Ik constateer wel dat er gelukkig een proportionele actie was. Zeer gericht op die chemische wapenproductiefaciliteit. En dat is ook de reden dat we als Nederland daar begrip voor uitgesproken. Ja.
Presidente di Perù, tasso in chiamata continentale, ossia natur paese di continente americano, pa una di un'alleanza contro di corruzione ed in difesa di democrazia. E sa che durante la cumbre di jefe di Stato di e of di governo di organizzazione pa Stato americano.
Esta mesa es hoy el foco de atención del continente, que espera como resultado del diálogo político la adopción de acciones concretas para luchar contra la corrupción. Este flagelo es el principal impedimento para avanzar hacia una democracia de calidad que garantice la realización plena de los ciudadanos en un ambiente de libertad, desarrollo y goce de sus derechos. El Perú ha asumido el reto de luchar frontalmente contra la corrupción. Esta es la prioridad de mi gobierno y un lineamiento de nuestra política exterior. El Perú lideró en los meses previos a esta cumbre el proceso de consulta con los estados de la región, sociedad civil, sector privado, parlamentos, pueblos indígenas, jóvenes y otros actores sociales para identificar las reformas necesarias para fortalecer la lucha contra la corrupción en las Américas.
Il governo di Colombia ha dato un full appoggio a Ecuador in caso di assassinato di due periodisti ecuatoriani e anche di un chauffeur nella frontiera colombiano-ecuatoriano, di ex membro del gruppo guerriglia colombiano FARC. Il presidente colombiano Juan Manuel Santos ha confermato che ha constatato l'assassinato di due periodisti ecuatoriani e un chauffeur a tomar lugar in territorio colombiano, ossia in Colombia.
Pues mire, el ministro de Defensa, antes de viajar aquí a Medellín, me dijo que por fuentes de inteligencia se confirmaba que los cuerpos sí estaban del lado colombiano. Eso fue lo que me dijo el ministro de Defensa y en ese sentido pues tiene uno que suponer que fueron asesinados en Colombia.
E 13 ecuatorianos han quedado secuestrados por el 26 de marzo por el ex miembro de FARC que ha rechazado el acuerdo de paz entre el gobierno de Colombia y FARC. Cuaworth llama en la mesa frente Oliver Sinistera, encabezado por ex militante de FARC Walter Artizala alias Guacho. Ya viernes semana pasada, el presidente de Ecuador ha confirmado que el grupo ha ejecutado dos periodistas y un chofer y ha lanzado una misión policial militar de 550 agentes contra el grupo aquí. El operativo está continuando. Presidente di Mercata moralmente incapacitato per governare, sa che, secondo l'ex direttore di Officina Federale di Investigazione di Merca FBI, James Comey. L'ex direttore di FBI, che Trump ha quitto per il suo lavoro, ha pubblicato un book che mende e espressa in maniera più critica di il presidente americano. Il ministero dice che il book che non è per me, book. Di ex ambtenaar of alto oficial di il governo americano di il governo di Trump per perdere il lavoro e di suoi schibi un buco cammina per rivelare come il governo di Trump sta funzionando internamente contenendosi in una maniera non sappia allegazioni scandalose e vergognose e in alcun caso hasta incriminante di il presidente americano. Di un'intervista con Comey nel plant americano ABC ex direttore di FBI ha dichiarato contra la alegación existente, e no está considerado que Donald Trump está mentalmente o médicamente incapacitado. Está de hecho considerado Trump un hombre de inteligencia relativamente alto, pero con un nivel moral muy degenerante. Como tal, está considerado Trump moralmente incapacitado para gobernar el ex director de FBI James Comey.
You think the Russians have something on Donald Trump?
I think it's possible. I don't know. These are more words I never thought I'd utter about a president of the United States, but it's possible.
That's stunning. You can't say for certain that the president of the United States is not compromised by the Russians.
Yeah, it is stunning, and I wish I wasn't saying it, but it's just, it's the truth. It always struck me and still strikes me as unlikely, and I would have been able to say with high confidence about any other president I dealt with, but I can't. It's possible.
You write that President Trump is unethical, untethered to the truth. Is Donald Trump unfit to be president?
Yes, but not in the way I often hear people talk about it. I don't buy the stuff about him being mentally incompetent or early stages of dementia. He strikes me as a person of above average intelligence who's tracking conversations and knows what's going on. I don't think he's medically unfit to be president. I think he's morally unfit to be president.
How graphic did you get?
I think as graphic as I needed to be. I did not go into the business about people peeing on each other. And he interrupted, started talking about it. You know, do I look like a guy who needs hookers? I didn't answer that. And then I just moved on and explained, sir, I'm not saying that we credit this, not saying we believe it. We just thought it very important that you know.
What was the look on his face?
He was very defensive and started going into a list of people who had accused him of touching them improperly, sexual assault, and how he hadn't done this, he hadn't done that, he hadn't done that.
Do you believe his denial?
Honestly, never thought these words would come out of my mouth, but I don't know whether the current president of the United States was with prostitutes peeing on each other in Moscow in 2013. It's possible. But I don't know.
How weird was that briefing?
Really weird.
Questa qui, final di nostra parte internazionale, un pausa breve di sostback e deporti.